limufa assembling isi ikitambla gina ichi bako ikitambla ikitambla urejmo wali ni to asina ten mawe akumumo wali ni laso wala na kibarako ala kichingi na mokwe ala puti zato na mapu
epi kito ageresa keke amlinga kenyo meme ikimu ikina debi dege tena igana hospital kiape ikisara avortement kirikiri
biko bi nango deja et biko ipimba biko bidunga gina yanga chi akare kojo I usemlinga etminzo.
Felicité, Christine and Kosinga are just three amongst over a million people in the Central African Republic to have fled into the bush to escape the violence raging in their country. The fact that they are women, however, makes their ordeal even more harrowing. On the 8th of March, International Women's Day, like any other day, thousands of women in the world will leave their homes in order to flee war or persecution. There are nearly 45 million people worldwide, mainly women and children, living in a situation of forced displacement. A third of them seek refuge abroad. The others remain within the boundaries of their own country. When displaced, women and young girls often find themselves alone. Without protection, without their families, and with a government generally in a state of collapse or under attack, they find themselves exposed to all sorts of violence.
When they move into one place to another, they will be exposed, for example, to sexual violence because they have to cross borders, so the guardians or the guards in those borders are going to ask them for sexual favors in terms of, I will let you pass if you do this for me. Once they are in the new setting, in the new refugee camp or whatever, they will be exposed to sexual attacks when they go for water, when they go for food, when they go to the latrines to get changed because they got their menses, their periods. So in all these situations, they're very, very exposed.
In conflicts, rape can be used as a weapon, as a deliberate tactic to induce psychological fear and to humiliate victims. In the Democratic Republic of Congo and the Central African Republic, thousands of women can attest to that. But there are other dangers too. Some women may be pregnant when they are forced to flee their homes. Others may become pregnant as a result of rape, or simply because they no longer have access to contraception. And giving birth in such conditions is not only difficult, it's highly dangerous too.
Every woman in the world is exposed to have a life-threatening complication during delivery. That means that 15% of the normal deliveries, that all deliveries happening in a year, 15% of them will face a life-threatening complication. If you don't have access to healthcare, what is usual in an emergency setting because they are in a refugee camp, but probably the healthcare didn't arrive, they will probably die.
It's the same for these Somali refugees in Kenya and these South Sudanese women in Uganda. For their own survival, as well as that of their newborns, all these women, Felicity, Christine and Kosinga too, need protection, obstetric care and access to family planning.
Mm-hmm.